Good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Santos Capellan Jr. wishing you a good day. Okay, now in this video, what I'm going to do is show you a video of actual programming and commissioning of a DDC panel. Because in my previous tutorials, I'm giving you an idea how to become a BMS engineer. Okay, now in this video, I want to show you one of the scopes of work of a BMS engineer. So this is an actual programming and commissioning of a DDC panel, okay? Now, let me show you the video. Okay, as you can see, this is a DDC panel, cable pulled and all the I/O modules and the base controller. This is the base controller. These are the I/O modules, okay? I have here a digital I/O modules and this combination of I/O modules, okay? Then all these cables are already pulled. All these cables are properly tagged so that during your testing and commissioning or your testing of this DDC panel, you will base the testing in a DDC drawing. So the cables must be all cable tagged properly. Okay, so that you don't have problem in checking the operation. Okay, now this DDC handles the operation of our chilled water system secondary pumps. Okay, now secondary pumps, these are the pumps that delivers the chilled water requirement of all the air handling units in this building. Okay, so basically you will find these secondary pumps in the basement area of the building or in the upper roof. Okay. Now in this project, this is in the basement. Okay. Now let me continue the video. Okay. As I said in my previous tutorial, as a BMS engineer, you should be also capable of designing the control panel or designing the DDC panel because you have to properly size your control transformer for this DDC panel. Okay, now all these I/O modules, the base controllers, you need to know how to calculate the total power requirement of each modules, and of course, what are the power requirements of all the field devices that is connected from this DDC, because all these field devices, let's say you have some power, you have some pressure sensors that requires power supply. The power supply of that field device will be coming from this DDC panel. Okay. Now all the field devices for the BMS will take the power supply from the DDC panel. So as a BMS engineer, you should be able to calculate what is the total power requirement of all the field devices connected to this DDC panel, and also consider the I/O modules and the base controller. Okay, so you have to know the power requirement of each equipment. Okay, now let me continue the video. So this is the base controller. Okay, now I think this is a this base controller can handle 500 points. Okay, so meaning these cables or this the DDC points for this DDC panel is it can go up to 500, maximum 500 points. Okay, let's continue. Okay, by programming commissioning, you don't need to do this in the front-end computers or in the BMS room, because by the use of a laptop, you can always go to the DDC panel itself, connect the DDC to the, connect the laptop to the DDC, then you can have communication to that DDC itself, okay? So you can download and check all the monitoring points being controlled and monitored by this DDC panel. Okay, let's continue. Now, as I said, this DDC controls and monitors the operation of the chilled water system. As you can see here, I am showing you one big MCC motor control. Now, in my previous video, I've shown you one small BFD. Actually, inside of this motor control center is a big BFD that controls or vary or controls the RPM of the chilled water pump. Okay, so BFD, as you know, it is used to change the or change the speed of the motor. So changing the speed of the motor also changes the volume of the chilled water it is delivering. Okay, so let's continue the video. Okay, so there are around four big MCC. As I said, if you are a BMS engineer, you should be also capable of designing the MCC. Now you will be opening this motor control and you will be terminating your control cable going to the DDC panel. As I said, when you are doing BMS work near a motor control center with variable frequency drive, it can create interference. Now I take in consideration this scenario. So I tried to install the DDC panel, I think around 3 meters away from this motor control center because of the interference. Now I tried also to insulate the cables going to these motor control centers, because if you are not careful in pulling the cable and your BMS cable run across this big power supply, then it will create interference in your DDC. Then your DDC might suffer interference and it might not work properly. Okay, so let's continue. I, by the way, you can hear the sound because all the equipments are already running in manual. We are just checking our program, downloading it and checking it. Then after that, we are putting it in automatic to see if our program is working properly. And as I said, you should be always working hand in hand with mechanical and electrical engineers of the project, so you will not encounter any more problem. Okay, so let's continue. Okay, as you can see here, those are the big pumps. So these are the big chilled water pumps that delivers chilled water requirement in this building. So, okay guys, I have seen you an actual work of a BMS engineer. This is a challenging work for a BMS engineer. Okay, so if you really want to join this field, you have to do a lot of self-study, like studying how an HVAC equipment works and how you will do some networking for your controllers and for your computer. Okay, I think this is enough for this tutorial. I have given you a clear picture of one of the tasks of a BMS engineer. So thank you very much. And thank you for watching this video. And bye for now.